Welcome back. So today we will discuss a new topic, which is rigid bodies equilibrium two dimension. Okay, so rigid bodies equilibrium two dimension. So what we have seen before is a equilibrium 2D, but for particle. And now today we are expanding this application into rigid bodies. Okay, so we see some similarity and some differences between particle and also rigid body. Okay, so then when we talk about equilibrium, of course the thing that come in our mind is the forces, the moment equal to zero. So we have sigma fx and fy, because it is 2D, so only two, fx and fy equal to zero. And we have the third one, which is sigma moment equal also to zero. Okay, sigma moment at any point you take and on that rigid body, the moment will be equal to zero at any point. Okay, so we have three equations: sigma fx, sigma fy, sigma moment. So normally for the sake of our class, okay, the question will ask you only up to three unknown. You have three questions with three unknown, you can solve that one pretty easily. Okay, so when we talk about equilibrium, okay, the thing that always come to us is we have to draw free body diagram. Okay, so we have draw a lot of free body diagram in the particle, but now for rigid body it is same thing, just adding some reaction force. So we have the first one, draw boundary of chosen section, because in the rigid body we have several rigid body which combine together, okay, make it a structure. So we have to choose what section we want to draw, what component we want to draw rigid body. We take only that section, so draw a boundary of the chosen section. Okay, and then if the rigid body have mesh, some rigid in the question that you will see that some have mesh, some didn't, it depend on the question. Okay, if the component have mesh, so you have to put the mg downward. This one you already know, put the mg downward. But the thing is, now compared to particle, we have to make sure that the mg is acting on the center of gravity of that component. Must on the center of gravity of that component. For the particle is easy, because in only a particle the center of gravity is right on that particle itself. But for rigid body, the center of gravity might be different for different shape of the rigid body. So be careful for this one, make sure it is on the center of gravity. And then we have to put the external forces. Okay, given any external forces, including if we have a spring, okay, and a cable and so on. Okay, including spring and cable, external forces. Normally in the equation they will give you F1, F2, T1, T2, T3, and their spring and so on. So that is considered as external forces. So you have to put external forces. And the third one is the reaction force. In terms of reaction force and also moment. Okay, so reaction force we will discuss in detail now after this one. Okay, one of the external forces that we have already learned before is the normal force. The reaction force. Okay, normal force is one of the reaction force, normal force and also friction. We have seen the friction, you have also seen the normal force before, so that is also considered as external force, they're considered as reaction force. Okay, so that's how you want to draw the free body diagram. So first, before you solve the problem, you have to make sure that you draw a correct free body diagram, because all this equation will come out based on that free body diagram. So if you have a incorrect free body diagram, of course the equation will be also wrong and your answer also will be wrong. So please make sure you know how to draw the free body diagram correctly. Okay, and the drawing of free body diagram is important, so that in our syllabus we really want you to master this one, because we will carry out to other subject later on. So in our test normally we have a specific question only for free body diagram. Okay, specific question only for drawing the free body diagram, one in our test and the other one is in the final exam, only to draw the free body diagram. So you really have to master how to draw this free body diagram. Okay. So before we go to drawing several free body diagram, we go to the reaction force first. Reaction force and moment, because this is a new thing here. The other thing is what we have already learned. So the new thing here is the reaction force. So reaction force, you can refer to this book, which is table 9.2, page 103. So this one. Okay, so we are referring to this table that explained to us this reaction force. The table here is the figure, and then the table before it is the explanation of what is what and how and why it is come to how we make the figure of reaction force. Okay, so in brief, we have several listed here. We will see this kind of reaction force later on during three dimension. Now we are in two dimension. We go to three dimension later on, you see there's similarity and some difference when we go to the three dimension. Okay, so in two dimension, first we start by a component with a roller or a component that is moving on a surface with frictionless surface, which is mu. I put it here, mu equal to zero, which is a frictionless surface, meaning that if the component moving on the surface, okay, for example, if this component moving on the surface, okay, the surface is frictionless, okay, so that the component is free to move at any direction on this surface, okay, because it is frictionless. There's no friction that pushing the opposite direction. If there is friction, there will be another forces. Okay. So, but now imagine that this surface is frictionless, really smooth surface, nothing here. So you can move freely. Okay. The idea of reaction force is the force that counter the movement of that component. Okay. If there is a force that push the component from moving. Okay, counter the component from moving, there will be a reaction force. So it is free to move in any direction, so there's no reaction force here. But see here, my component can be moved this way, so there's no reaction force on y direction. Can be moved this way. It can also move, let's say this is y and this is x. Y and x, there's no reaction force going up here. There's no reaction force going left or right, so meaning there's no in x direction, but this component cannot go inwards inside the surface. So there will be one reaction force that push the component from going in the surface. Okay, so in this case, you will see that there's no reaction force in this direction, but there will be one force that pushing the component from going inside the surface. Okay, so this force must be 90 degrees to the surface towards the component, 90 degrees to the surface towards the component, because when the component want to go inside, they will feel that something pushing outward towards the component. The component will feel that. So we have reaction force at that component. Of course, if you want to draw the reaction force at the surface itself, you will find that the surface will feel one component pushing the surface. Okay, so opposite direction. Same magnitude, opposite direction. So first one here, free to move at any other direction, only towards the component, it will be one reaction force. That what we call before, we call it this one as normal force. Normal force. Okay, 90 degree to the surface towards the direction of the component. This is the normal force. Okay, second one. It is a roller or slot, but I still mention here it is mu equal to zero, so meaning that it is frictionless roller or slot. Okay, frictionless roller or slot. If you can see, if I have for example, we have here a piston. You can see that this piston, this one, will move inside this slot. Okay, will move inside this slot. Okay, so we have the thing, which is we put the lubricant and so on, so to make that this friction, this piston can move freely inside the slot without any friction, so we call it as frictionless slot or roll collar. Okay, so the component, this component can move up and down only in that slot. Or if your collar here, it can also move up and down, but only on the slot. Okay, if it is frictionless, so that meaning that there's no friction holding that. So this one, we take this component. Okay, so this is the point here. So the only thing that this component will feel is something that pushing here, right? We have something here, inside here, we also have something there. Okay, there's only one point where component will be touched with the component A will touch with the slot. Okay, and the component will not touch both sides. If it touch both sides, meaning that it's really fit and the component cannot move. In order to component to move, it only touching at one side. Even if the clearance is too small, 0.001 mm for example, or 0.1 mm, but there's still a clearance. If there's no clearance, the component cannot move. It will stuck if both sides touching. Okay, so the idea is only one side will touch, the other side will have a small clearance so that the component can still moving. So only at one point that the component will touch. So what we do is, first one, the reaction force here, you have to draw the slot line, which is this one and this one. So you have to draw this slot line. Okay, that's the first step, drawing the slot line or the collar line. And then, knowing that we only touch at one point, not the both points, so you should have one normal force toward this line. Okay, 90 degrees toward this line. This way or this one. Okay, choose one. You cannot put both. If you put both, it will be wrong. Because you put both, meaning that you agree it is touching at two sides, it will not moving. So only at one side. So that's why it is either A or B. So A or B. So A or B, not both. Only one. Okay, so the first step is to draw the line, the collar line. Okay, the slot line, and then one force 90 degrees to that line, either A, this side, or that side, the other side. Only one of it. Okay, there is four slot. The third one is a pin joint. Maybe I have this one, pin joint. Okay, this one is a pin joint. Notice that it can move these directions freely, any direction. Okay, it can move freely this direction. So it don't have any moment. Okay, because it can move freely. Okay, but I cannot move this component to X direction, both direction X, and I also cannot move this component like this one, because one of the part is fixed. If it did not fit, it can move this way and this way. So it cannot move in X direction, and also it cannot move in Y direction. So both direction will have the reaction force. Remember that reaction force is the thing that pushing the component from moving. So it will have two reaction force, which is pushing the component from moving in X direction, the other one is pushing the component from Y direction. So we have two direction. Okay, if this component as A, normally we put it is as AX and AY. It doesn't matter if you want to put in this way, which is AX and AY, positive X, positive Y, or you want to put this way, this one, AY, AX, is also okay. Or if you want to put AX, AY, the other direction, also okay. Okay, but normally we'll start by both positive direction, positive X and positive Y. We'll put that as a normally, but if you want to against the normality and you want to go opposite direction, it's also okay, because you don't really know which direction. Okay, but it is always on the X direction. Okay, on the X axis and on the Y axis. Okay, so you can put AX and AY. Okay, there is the reaction force for the pin. Okay, later on. Okay, no problem, we continue with this one. So the pin can move in any direction, can move freely, but cannot move on X and on Y. So we have AX and AY. The other one is on rough surface. Okay, on rough surface. Rough surface, same like this first one. The difference is now the surface is rough. So when I move the component in X direction here, there is a friction that counter the movement. So there is a reaction force, which is the friction force that counter my movement. And still it can move in this direction. Why? But it cannot go down towards the surface. So it will copy this one plus the friction. Okay? So this one you will have one force 90 degree to the surface towards the component plus friction. Okay, plus the friction force. Okay, so plus 90 degree to the surface towards the component, and this one is on the surface, which is parallel to the surface. And if you put downward or upward, it doesn't matter. Okay, you can choose one of it, because you didn't know the component want to move upward or downward. So the reaction force, the friction will always counter the direction of motion. So if you want to move upward, the friction will go downward. If this component go down, the friction will go up. So you can choose one of it. Okay, so it will be two. One to counter the movement towards the surface. The other one is the friction, because the surface is rough. Okay, and the last one is fixed joint or welded joint. If you want to imagine this one, maybe I have this one. If I hold really tight this one, okay, so if I want to move this component to the X direction, it cannot move because it is already hold here. Okay, fixed. If I want to move the component to Y direction also, it cannot move, fixed. And plus, so there's already two. If this is point A, AX, AY, make sure when you draw the free body diagram, make sure you draw this head of the arrow. I don't want you to just draw like this, it's nothing, direction and so on. You have to draw the direction. Head of the arrow must be shown clearly. Okay, please, because there's a lot of you just draw the line without this head, because when we go further, there will be implication of this direction. Okay, there will be implication. For example, if this one, I'm drawing this AX and AY, this direction. If I want to draw the free body diagram on this pin, actually, this one is on this component, but now in this pin, I have to draw force opposite direction of what I'm drawing here. Same magnitude, but opposite direction from here. So that's why it is important for you to draw the arrow, the head of the arrow. Please draw that one. Okay, if you don't draw, I will give directly 0 marks. Okay, even though maybe for the free body diagram directly 0, but for the calculation, yes, maybe if you calculate it correctly, you have the answer. But for the free body diagram itself, you have 0 mark if you don't draw the arrow, the direction of the force, reaction force. Okay, now come back to here. You see that you cannot move in Y, cannot move in X, so we have AX and AY. But at the same time, this, when I hold it fixed, welded joint, you cannot move like this way. Okay, this one, you see, you can move freely. But if I'm holding like this one, you cannot move. Okay, meaning that there is one thing that holding this component from turn. That turning motion is moment. So there will be one moment. See here, there will be one moment as reaction force. Okay, so you normally, if you want to put it in positive direction, you will have AX to the right, AY upward. The moment will be counterclockwise, because we are using like this. So the moment will be counterclockwise as our positive direction of the moment. So it will be 3 here. One moment, because it cannot turn. The other one, it is freely to turn. On the surface, it is free to turn. The other one in the slot also, it free to turn. Here, it can free turn in wider in two dimension. Okay, and here it's also just on the surface, so free. This one, the difference is it cannot turn any direction. So the motion of turning that direction is the moment that holding the moment, the component from time. So here you have the reaction force. Okay, so by knowing that reaction force, we can go to the how to draw the free body diagram later on. Okay, so I hope this is clear. If there is some confusion, you can still go to your book. You have explanation in the page before the figure, so it explain to you why and why. So you can go and still read this book. Okay.